I got it, everyone! Our first color TV!
Come on, look, it's here!
Come on, give me an
answer!
There you go.
Open it, open it!
Hold down, huddle down on the couch and give your father some room to plug it in.
Come on, plug it in, Dad!
Oh boy, this is gonna be so great! Here goes! Are you ready? Are you ready?
Gonna make your body wet. Yeah, yes.
Always tell me that they feel we've grown up together. And it's the truth, we have grown up together. I remember being 7 and singing in front of the mirror with my niece Stacy. There's a lot of love in my family, and I guess I've always wanted to make my own name, have my own identity. But ever since Control took off, my life has been one wild trip. But the truth is that I really feel like my journey is just beginning.
Ladies and gentlemen, Outkast, with the original Miss Jackson, Janet Jackson.
Yeah, this one right here goes out to Miss Jackson, better known as Penny.
Thank you.
TV icon, Janet Jackson, featuring Aaliyah, Phil Bellamy, Taye Diggs, Christina Aguilera.
Hey, I'm Christina Aguilera, and I will be the opening presenter tonight, showing my support for Janet Jackson.
DJ Quick, Jamie Foxx, David Alan Greer, NSYNC's Justin Timberlake, and Chris Kirkpatrick.
We're here tonight to do a testimonial for Miss Jackson herself, and we did a special vocal tribute to her, and we hope it doesn't work.
D.L. Hughley, The Jackson, Katherine Jackson, Michael Jackson, Britney Spears.
She's mesmerizing. I looked up to her since I was a little girl.
Jimmy Jam, Janet's fourth grade teacher, Cheryl Womack, Busta Rhymes.
I am just here to salute one of music's known and undeniable generals. And we know that general is Janet Jackson.
Method Man, Redman, Jessica Simpson, Tyrese, Shaquille O'Neal, and Stevie Wonder. With performances by Outkast, Buck Cherry, Macy Gray.
What's going on? Love will never do. Hey, what's going on? That's one of my favorite songs. I love that.
An all-star dance tribute featuring Maya, Usher, and Pink.
Hi, I'm Pink, and I'm dancing. Wish me luck.
And Destiny's Child.
What's up with Destiny's Child? We'll be performing Let's Wait a While.
By Janet Jackson.
Please welcome Christina Aguilera.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to MTV Icon honoring Janet Jackson. I'm part of a generation that's grown up watching videos and loving Janet. Some artists follow a path and others blaze a trail. I remember watching MTV when I was younger and being mesmerized by videos like What Have You Done For Me Lately? And When I Think of You. To me, Janet had it all. Amazing videos, hot songs, and the sexiest moves. She's always in style and in control. Tonight on this stage, Janet Jackson's gonna take her next leap forward. But first, we put together some of today's biggest artists to give Janet her props. You're gonna know the tunes, but you've never heard or seen them like this. Through song and dance, words and images, the story of a groundbreaking singer, dancer, songwriter, and performer. I'm talking about the first MTV icon, Miss Jackson, Janet Jackson. This is where the story begins. This is a story about control.
In 1985, we thought we knew Janet Jackson. She was the youngest daughter of America's best-loved musical family, the smiling girl we'd seen grow up as an actress on television.
Hi.
Hi.
But beneath her bubblegum image was a shy young woman who had struggled with a childhood in the limelight, where decisions were made for her. A Janet still recovering from the shattering end of an early marriage. A Janet who, at 18, needed desperately to break free and become her own person.
I wanted my own identity so badly, it wasn't even funny. I didn't want people to know that I was a Jackson. I wanted to make it on my own and not write any of my brothers or sisters' coattails whatsoever.
Janet was ready to take a chance, so she and her father headed north to the Twin Cities of Minnesota and the production team of Jimmy Jam and Terry Lewis, already successful in their own right through their work with Prince and their crafting of the Minneapolis sound.
We had a meeting.
Okay, let me think if I can remember this meeting. My father was there saying, I don't want my daughter sounding like Prince. Don't make her sound like Prince.
No, no, Mr. Jackson, it's going to be cool. It's, you know, it's going to be her own sound. When she came to Minneapolis, the first week we didn't do anything but just kind of hang out.
I mean, we had the best time. We drove around, he showed me around the whole city.
Just kind of doing stuff, and we were having these conversations.
It was quite a bit at that time in my life that I had gone through, and we talked about it all.
After about 4 or 5 days, we showed her the lyric ideas we came up with, and she said, oh. She said, this is what we were talking about. And she said, okay, I get it. So just whatever I want to talk about, that's what we're going to do. And it's like, yeah. And she said, okay, great.
It was very freeing for me to write my own music, to express the way that I felt.
I'm gonna make my own decision.
In 1986, Control became Janet's first number one album, selling 10 million copies and launching an incredible 6 hit singles. She had now become a successful artist by delving into her own emotions and making music on her own terms.
I think it's interesting that she had great producers on her first two records, and the records didn't really do anything. So it's more or less when she talked about her own ideas and put her musical ideas forth that the success really happened.
I didn't like it that much, because it was saying she was in control, and I thought she was too young to be sending a message out there.
There was no controversy with that family whatsoever. They could just all sing and dance. And when she put out Control, we finally had a Jackson with some edge.
It's all about control. My control. And this time, I'm going to do it my way.
Please welcome the independent women of Destiny's Child.
Before we ever met her, we all loved Miss Janet Jackson.
When I was younger, I was in a dance group. We were called the Smooth Dancers. And we were straight up Janet Jackson. We did Rhythm Nation, we did Escapade, we did it all. And we used to win up everything at the competitions because we learned it from Miss Janet.
The song we're gonna sing is one with a great message for young people.
And girl, can I relate to this song right now? Because if Janet Jackson said it was cool to wait a while, you knew it was really cool to slow down, calm down, and not to rush.
There's something I want to tell you. There's something I think that you should know. It's not that I shouldn't really, really love you. Let's take it slow. When we get to know each other,
I'm not afraid to die.
playing around.
Let's break it down real fast, y'all.
Let's wait a while before it's too late. Let's wait a while before we go too far. Let's wait a while. Before it's too late, let's wait a while before
we go too far. Baby, let's wait a while
before it's too late. Before we go too far.
We love you, Janet.
I love you. I loved it.
We saw grooving to the end. Yeah. The end groove. She was like feeling it. I was like, yeah, she liked it.
They sound great. It trips me out really, but I'm just overwhelmed right now.
Coming up, Jenny Fox gets nasty.
I'm getting ready to roast Janet like you've never seen before.
Tasty.
In chapter 2 of Janet Jackson's story, Janet goes from shocking the world to changing it for the better with her concept album, Rhythm Nation. And later, NSYNC's very special vocal tribute to Janet.
That was Dancing Moonlight. Now here's something new for you folks. Enjoy.
Good night, dear.
Good night, dear.
Jamie Foxx.
What up? Make some noise. What up? Everybody's out here to give Janet Jackson some special props. That's all good. Give it up for Janet. Miss Jackson, if you're nasty. I'm out here though, cause I gotta let some stuff off my chest. I got a little secret, you know. I got a little secret. Can I share? A lot of people don't know this, but me and Janet been married for about eight days. You know, off and on, you know what I'm saying? And I mean, and I know it, you know what I'm saying? She knows it, but now it's time to let the whole world know it. Let the whole world know it, see? This was like our own little photo shoot we did at the crib, and then Rolling Stone kind of stole that from us, you know. You know, Janet was doing her thing too, you know what I'm saying? I love Janet because she got big hands, you know? Lisa, big hands. And Michael was there too. Michael was there. I like Michael Jackson because he got big hands too. But you know, Janet, this is a very big night for you. You know, a few people wanted to be here and everything, you know. And your co-star, Jimmy J.J. Walker, wanted to be here from Good Times, but he was stuck in the 70s. And who can forget Florida? She wanted to be here, but she died. But I'm sure that if she wasn't there, she'd be here. It was all good. The Vice President, Dick Cheney, wanted to be here, but his heart just wasn't into it. I mean, his heart really wasn't into it. Puff Daddy wanted to shoot down, you know, give a shout out and everything. But unfortunately, he's in New York going from J-Lo to J-Lo. Because I'm going to tell you, in this business, there's a big difference between icon and ex-con. But you know, we're doing our thing. Janet, I know this is a little rough for you, but I'm here for you tonight. You know, if you want to have an escapade, it's all right with me. Because I'm all about your pleasure principle. And I will rub your black cat all night long, because that's the way my love goes. Love you.
Please welcome Shaquille O'Neal.
Let's be real here. I've got every Janet Jackson video ever made memorized by heart, you might say. But if push comes to shove, and sometimes push does come to shove, I've got to say my favorite is Rhythm Nation. She was so tough, so sexy and so fine, and she could kick your ass and break your heart and open up your mind. Let's take a look.
We are in a race between education and catastrophe.
Using control as a formula for success, Janet's record label pushed for more of the same in her much-anticipated follow-up album.
You hear things like, oh, this is going to be a fluke. They wanted me to do a control, too. And I was set out to prove certain people wrong.
On 1989's Rhythm Nation, Janet took the world as her subject. Its sorrow, its injustice, the millions of people who felt lost or left behind. Their concerns became hers, and she spoke out on their behalf in a language everyone could understand.
The homeless Helen Crump.
We would watch a lot of TV, and the TV would constantly be switching between MTV and CNN.
They have a lot of documentaries with prostitution, child abuse, drugs.
We could have called the record Escapade. And then put the four or five more conscious cuts at the end of the record. But her thing was, no, we got to start the record, boom, boom, state of the world, the knowledge. You know, I think the record company was a little bit like, pretty heavy stuff.
Well, I got my way.
Even as Rhythm Nation outsold Control, its underlying message created a new social consciousness in fans worldwide. And on the road, she put her money where her mouth was.
$0.25 from each ticket on this tour for the whole 9 months of the tour is being given to a Washington, D.C. group called Cities in School.
A lot of things were brought to my attention, different charities, and I wanted to get involved and hopefully help in some sort of way.
Janet has maintained that commitment ever since. And on Rhythm Nation, in the face of overwhelming commercial and creative pressure, Janet not only did well, she did good.
I had a great deal of faith in myself. And the Rhythm Nation album was even more successful than the Control album.
Different of the world unites, strength the numbers, we can get it right one time.
Ladies and gentlemen, a musical icon in his own right, Stevie Wonder.
She is lovely. She is wonderful. Janet is all that and more. I remember Janet when she was a little girl with a voice that sounded like this.
Hi, I'm Janet, Mr. Stevie.
No, but seriously, I've known the Jackson family for a long time. I remember little Janet when she could barely talk, much less sing. When she could barely walk, much less dance. Yet I'm so very, very proud of Janet. She's grown into an icon for a generation even younger than she is. She's done more than make hit records. She's made a statement. And here to sing one of Janet's classic songs, another shining talent. Where are the cue cards? Okay. And here's another shining talent of the MTV era. A woman with a lot to say, a great voice. Please welcome the incomparable Macy Gray.
Thank you.
NSYNC speaks from the heart.
I'm gonna start crying.
No, I think she's just amazing. You know, she does her thing and she doesn't look back.
Method Man and Redman put the fans to the test.
We love you.
We love you, Miss Jackson.
We love you, Miss Jackson.
We know the deal.
And in Chapter 3, Janet's world stardom attracts the most loyal and inspiring fans. And later, Janet owns the stage.
This song right here has to do with Terry's fantasy. We're putting baby all over Janet and just lightly tapping her booty with a Louisville Slugger. Nothing hard, nothing rough, just a little. You hear this? Right there, that's a constant bang right there on that booty. You nasty. That's nasty.
Ladies and gentlemen, Method Man and Red Man.
Yo, calm down. Shut up. Shut up. Hey, yo, I knew Janet was an icon from the first time I seen her as Little Penny on Good Times.
Little.
As Charlene on Different Strokes.
Different Strokes.
She was on Fame, but don't nobody remember what her name was.
Me neither.
But she was still fine.
She was fine.
Hey, yo, now, y'all been making a lot of noise so far.
A whole lot of noise.
Acting like y'all know about Janet's music.
And don't know nothing.
But we about to test y'all skills.
Word, test y'all skills.
We got DJ Quick on the one and twos.
That's my dog.
So if y'all know the words to the songs, we want y'all to sing along.
Come on.
Come on. Come on.
Come on.
Who's that in that nasty car? Come on. Who's that eating that nasty food? Who's jumping to this nasty groove? Hold up. Y'all don't understand, but I'ma learn y'all. We gonna try another one. We're gonna try another one. Check this out. What have you done for me lately? Come on, crowd.
Hold on, lady, sir.
I can't hear you. Come on. What have you done for me lately?
What?
Come on. And yeah. Jenny gives a lot of love to her fans.
Word up.
And there's a lot of love that she gets back and is well deserved.
Uh-huh.
So as our icon, we're going to take a look at what she got to do.
Your fans are really remarkable.
They are. They're very dedicated. I love you guys so much.
Ever since Rhythm Nation, Janet has nurtured her relationship with her fans. She connects with them, cares about them, and perhaps taking a page from her own life, goes out of her way not to make anyone feel excluded. But Janet's dedication reached a new level with the touching story of Kia and Keisha Croft, two sisters who had dropped out of school.
I know some people don't think a song or an album can change your life, but that's so in our case. By listening to your song, the knowledge it made us realize how important an education is.
They listened to that song and it just turned their lives completely around. They graduated from high school and went on to college from there. And they actually gave me their tassels. And I thought that was the sweetest thing. So I wanted to give something back, so I had them framed. And I gave them back to them because they did the hard work.
Through years of growth and touring, Janet's music has not only impacted her listeners, but has also inspired some fans to pursue their own careers in music.
I remember the first time I went to her show, I was just like, oh my God, like I wanted to be her.
I met Brittany just a few days ago.
Just a couple days ago, how did that go?
I saw her show. I was like, hi, I really admire you. And I was such a retard, but she was really sweet.
She said that I inspired her a great deal, and that's so flattering for
me.
Please welcome a man who's got his groove, Taye Diggs.
Hey, y'all. Hey, Janet. About 10 years ago, I was in New York City dancing at this club, USA. I don't know if you remember.
Yeah.
And me and my people were just chilling, dancing. Then we had heard that Janet was in the house. So we saw her up in the balcony staring down, and we had convinced ourselves that she was looking for dancers for her next tour. So we were just chilling, dancing. We were like, is she looking? She ain't looking. Is she looking? Oh, she's looking. We did that for about 15 minutes, and she just left, and I became an actor. But, all right. But we got another fan here tonight. I'd like to bring her out. Her name is Desiree Joseph from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, and she's got a few words to say. Let's hear it for Desiree. Where you at? There we go.
Hi, I'm so proud to be here today to represent all the Janet Jackson fans out there whose lives have been touched by her music. A great song can help you through rough times. I know this firsthand. In 1998, I lost someone who I love very much in a car accident. I turned to Janet's song, Together Again, and it helped me get through the pain. Thank you, Janet. For your music of beauty and hope. Now I'd like to read a little of the poem I wrote for you. She'll never be able to hide her very strong sense of pride. She's beautiful inside and out, as so is the voice that comes out of her mouth. When she looks at you, she doesn't see the color of your skin, but she does see what lies within. I love you, Janet, and I mean every word.
From NSYNC,
Justin Timberlake and Chris Kirkpatrick.
We love Janet for a whole lot of reasons.
Yeah, like, she's fine.
When things were just starting out for NSYNC, Janet took us with her on the Velvet Rope Tour and taught us what being professional is all about.
Yeah, like how to be fine.
One of our favorite Janet Jackson videos is That's the Way Love Goes, because that video had the coolest, most laid-back groove.
Yeah, she's fine in the video, too. Fine.
We want to do something special for you, Janet, so we all figure we try to repaint a masterpiece, and we just hope we did it justice. Check it out.
And if we don't, you still fine. That's the way it goes.
An all-star dance tribute like you've never seen.
Me and Usher and Maya are about to tease you guys with a little Janet.
And in Chapter 4, Janet's innovative videos impact the world. And later, Janet gives us an over-the-top glimpse of where she's taking us in the future. Alan Grier and Busta Rhymes.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
We haven't
fun up in here, Buster, ain't we?
Yeah, see, tonight.
What's up, baby? You bling bling and look at you. Let the people see them diamonds. Look at that. That's beautiful, brother. You need a bank account. Anyway, I can't help but notice, dawg.
Yeah, dawg.
You did a video with Janet Jackson, didn't you? You know, look like everybody done got down with Janet except for the kid.
I know, what's wrong with you,
and
brother?
And if you ask me, there's only one profound flaw in Janet Jackson's videos.
And what's
and that? That's the fact that the kid ain't in it.
Even without Dave in her videos, she still has left an incredible mark on our musical culture.
By the early 90s, Janet had created more than a dozen music videos, revolutionizing the field using fashion and choreography to convey the messages of her music.
Embarrassed with videos that go that far back. Let's Wait a While, But If You Don't Feel Me Lately, Nasty. There are certain things that I see that I don't think anyone else truly is paying any attention to, but I really get embarrassed. That's just me.
By 1990, Janet had nothing to be embarrassed about with her daring skin-bearing video, Love Will Never Do Without You.
People do talk about that video because I showed skin. I mean, I was always covered up to here. Finally showed a little cleavage for the first time and a little stomach. I wanted to do something different. La, la, la,
la. Intimate or out there, political or personal, Janet's videos have signaled each of her many creative reinventions while also inspiring a new generation of young artists.
When I saw the Pleasure Principle, it inspired me to get into this business.
It was just solely me and not a group of dancers.
And I was a little girl trying to do every single move that she was doing.
Maybe that's why it stands out in people's minds, because it was just me. I don't know, but that comes up a great deal.
When it comes to dance, Janet sets the standard, which is why so many others have tried to follow in her dazzling footsteps.
Are you ready?
Please welcome Aaliyah.
The name Janet Jackson is synonymous with great dancing. I know her moves have influenced a lot of us in the industry. My personal favorite Janet video is All Right, which features Cab Calloway and has this really cool retro vibe and some amazing dance moves. To honor all the ways Janet has moved the world, please welcome some of today's finest movers and shakers, Pink, Usher, and Maya.
Yeah.
really was. I mean, I heard they worked really hard and they were practicing and they were keeping me abreast. And it's not easy choreography to do. It's all very intricate, everything that each one of the routines that you saw. And I heard Pink says she's never worked so hard in her life.
She smashed it.
Thank you.
She killed it.
What?
Crazy.
Thank you.
Coming up, Michael gets heartfelt. And in Chapter 5 of Janet's story, her toughest emotional time, Velvet Rope. Ladies and gentlemen, Janet's fourth grade teacher, Ms. Cheryl Womack.
I want all you young people out there to know that before she was an icon, Janet Jackson was a sweet, smart, and rather shy little girl in my fourth grade class at Lanai Road Elementary School in Encino, California. Can you spot her in this picture? That's her right there. I got to know Janet best when she stayed after school to talk about the things that were on her mind. She was a special kid then, and she's a special kid now. Janet, I used to give out golden stars, and now I can say I taught one.
Please welcome Tyrese.
What's up, LA?
When I was young is when I first was exposed to Janet Jackson, and it was from Good Times. And, you know, as a child, I even got irritated with the fact that they just didn't let her just join the cast and crew of the show. Because I'm like, all these cameos, you know, I want to see me some Janet Jackson as a child, you know? But the one thing that I've always respected and loved about Janet Jackson from the heart as an artist is that I meet a lot of artists myself, and we all have heard of arrogant and cocky artists who get the big head. She is as big as they get, and she is so humble, so gracious, very, very, very sweet. And that's just a prime example of what it really takes to become a superstar. You know, never, never let your head get too big for the door. Janet always seemed to transport us somewhere intimate with her music. And with the Velvet Rope, she took us closer than ever before.
There's nothing more depressing than having everything and still feeling sad.
At 10 years old, Janet was a TV actress. At 20, she was a music superstar. Now, at the age of 30, she was beginning to deal with the totality of her life as a woman. She was haunted by long-suppressed cruelties, disappointments, and heartbreaks. She struggled to make sense of her personal anguish, but for a time, the old sadness threatened to overwhelm her.
I think it happens in everybody's life. It surfaces at different times in their lives, and we have a choice of either continuing to suppress it or to deal with it. It happens to entertainers as well. We're human. We're no different. No different at all.
She was always very good at showing up at the studio. She would work, you know, 5 days straight or whatever. And on that project, there would be days and days she wouldn't show up. I just didn't realize the deepness of what was going on.
In time, she re-entered the studio and channeled her melancholy into lyrics more deeply felt than any she'd ever sung before. Up-tempo, defiant tracks that disclosed and chronicled her searing pain.
Some ask, was that something that happened in my life? Yes, because I do write what's going on in my life. But writing that album and going through what I was going through, it was so hard and cathartic, very therapeutic. Thank God I had people in my life that were so supportive and understood and helped me to continue and write about the rest of what was going on in my life.
The result was The Velvet Rope, Janet's most revealing album ever, a stunning testament to her personal triumph over despair, and maybe our closest look at the complex human being inside the superstar.
Anything that you ever want to know about her, you can listen to the records and kind of know what she's going through at any given time. I think that touches people. I think it's very inspirational.
major growth for me, that album was. That point in my life.
Please welcome Jessica Simpson.
A career like Janet Jackson's, and for my generation, she has always been there as an example that it can be done. That's one of the reasons why I do Escapade on stage. Janet's music translates across all platforms. Here to do a totally nasty rendition of a Janet classic, please welcome Buck Cherry.
Older brothers, the Jacksons, give love to their little sister. And in Chapter 6 of Janet's story, it's anyone's guess where the MTV icon will take us over the next 15 years. When MTV launched Reunion in Years, put your hands together for the legendary Jacksons.
Janet, we're very, very proud of you, and most of all, we're very excited to be here tonight. I just want to say that to share this moment with you is very special for all of us, and I have to get this in. I just saw the TV guide the other day, and you are looking so fine, okay? I love you. I'm your brother.
Yeah, Janet, and I know you might be thinking somebody's missing. Randy's a little bit under the weather, but he sends his love to you, sweetheart. Congratulations. And Michael wanted to be a part of this big night for you, too. So Let's take a look and see what Michael has to say.
Janet, I am so thrilled that you are being honored tonight as an icon. No one deserves this more than you. You have achieved so much and will only keep climbing higher and higher. Your talent knows no boundaries. I love you, and I am honored and proud to be your brother.
Now, Janet, we remember when we used to change your diaper backstage. But look at you now, all grown up, looking grand. Bam! But Janet, you know what? You will always be our baby sister. Always be our baby sister.
That's right. That's
and I guess to the rest of the world, you're an icon now.
That's right, baby.
As a beautiful woman and a fantastic artist, you managed to stay one step ahead.
After 15 years of hit singles, breakthrough videos, world tours, feature films, and charity work, Janet Jackson has only just begun. Despite the recent divorce after her secret marriage to longtime associate Renee Elizondo Jr., Janet is at peace with herself, as her much-anticipated new album hopes to convey.
Yes, a happy album. There's stuff going on in my life, but that's not the only thing that's going on in my life. There's a whole other side, and I'm in a different space. I'm experiencing things I never experienced before. I mean, just the simple thing of dating, really, and being 34. Right? Like I said, growing up very sheltered, I never did that before. So now I'm doing that, and my friends are teaching me about this whole thing.
She is an MTV artist. A lot of artists that MTV played videos when MTV first started were artists who were already established as, you know, radio artists. But there were artists that came up after MTV that really, their whole vision was a visual medium along with music. And she is part of that.
She started back in the beginning and she really made dance videos popular.
She just has this presence that, you know, you're just so drawn to her, you can't keep your eyes off her.
She's a great singer, she's a great dancer, and she's been fighting for what she believes in, and that is music.
And all the fame, she's still the same daughter. She's lovable, and she's still sweet. And I just want to say I love her to death.
Daughter, dancer, sister, singer, creator, actor, artist, fighter, inspiration, icon.
I think I'm more of the now person and looking at things that are going on in my life at the moment. My brother always said to me, he said, stop and enjoy what you have accomplished. Don't always work so hard and just keep going and keep going. And before you look back, everything has passed you by and you haven't sat there and just sat back to really take in everything that you've accomplished and now how blessed you truly are. And that's when it all started for me. And I try to live in the moment and take it one day at a time, one step at a time, and enjoy it. And I am. I can say that now. I am.
I have a need to feel real special.
So many.
All right. Now! Tonight, who participated, and I also want to thank everyone for coming. Thank you so much, and thank you to all the fans. I love you. Such a wonderful night, a special night in my life, an amazing night. Thank you so much because of you guys.
Do that. I got to go and give her a hug. She smells like roses.
Hi, my name is Method Man. I'm here to have sex with Janet Jackson.
Janet is my wife. We're going to make that announcement like later on this year.
You know, we married.
I think she was really digging me, you know?
Janet was looking at me the whole time.
Janet, I don't know, man. It's like there's an unspoken chemistry.
We've been down with Janet Jackson since the
get-go. We're here to see Janet.
That's right.
Janet is where it's at.
We do everything. And what we want you to do is take it from the top. You know, Black Cat, at the time, we had a Black Cat in the studio. And the Black Cat ran up under the thing. And Terry said, man, let's just throw that in the song. Black Cat. Right? Because we's looking for you, but we can't. You're gonna die.
And then Black Cat later on became the national anthem.
Mm-hmm.
Black Cat, You're Gonna Die,
mm-hmm.
became the national anthem of the Los Angeles Police Department, which we're really proud of.
Yeah, we're proud of that.
Yeah.